Yeah.
Welcome back to Character Select. What?
What?
Huh?
What?
Hey, it's Dave and Kanathis. It's a new recording session. Yeah,
hey.
Wait, there was something down here, but I already got it, right?
You already got that. Watch out for the invisible guys.
Are you fucking kidding me?
They're invisible. You have to use your x-ray visor.
No, I have to use the...
Oh.
No, I have to use the x-ray visor.
You can just barely
Holy
see
Christ.
Them. You can only barely see them.
Boom! Fuck off. Stop that.
Why do they have to be invisible? Oh.
The way they pulse and come at you? I mean, ooh. I'm starting to think you were right on those guys being the worst things ever.
I hate them so much. Ugh.
So... I know I said at the end of the last episode that between episodes I was going to go grab all the upgrades. I forgot.
Yes, you did. And now we have a mess on our hands.
Yeah. So one of the things that we did get off camera was we went back to the super incredible death tunnel, which we determined was super incredible death because there were like seven pillars in the way that you had to bomb.
Mm-hmm.
But thanks to the Phazon suit, we're immune to Phazon, so...
Probably actually impossible to get without the Phazon suit.
I would imagine so, considering it took off three things before I even bombed the first pillar. Like,
yes.
Christ.
That is, yeah.
But in the meantime, we did go back to that tunnel and we grabbed the thing that was in it, which is actually an artifact. So it was kind of important that we grabbed that.
Yes. Very important. Oh no, look out, Dave.
Get off of me, please. Oh shit, I don't have any... fucking power bombs.
You do not
Fuck.
Have power bombs, so you're gonna have to kill these guys the normal way.
Just gonna run.
Just gonna run.
Not in the mood.
Fleeing is generally unacceptable. Oh,
there's
a lot of them. Oh, they're very big and oh no, they're angry and they're big.
I hate fission Metroids.
I cannot really see. It is very dark.
Yeah. Fuck's
sake. Oh no. Oh, they're scary and big. Oh, they're big and scary. Oh no, they're oh no.
Okay.
Oh, right. It hurts. That's okay.
Everything is terrible forever.
Everything is terrible. Oh, it's fine now.
Okay, that sucked. I hate fission Metroids because unlike every other Metroid, they cannot be frozen. And on top of them not being able to be frozen, they also decide that when you do enough damage to kill them, they're going to split into two that are now immune to specific, or only vulnerable to specific beam weapons.
Yes.
Which is straight bull.
Very annoying. Very, very.
For anybody that's terribly curious, I'm trying to get to... I'm trying to get to... this room. Which is way the fuck back up top.
Way up top.
Oh, I got that guy with the fucking...
Whee! Yay!
The easiest power troopers of all.
Yeah, as long as you actually just shoot at them.
Ah, my controller is doing that weird thing with the sensor bar again. God damn it.
I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, I know you can't see it.
No, I cannot.
What was that?
What was what?
There was a sound. I heard a sound. It came from your microphone.
Did
don't
it?
Lie to me, Kanathis.
I don't...
Whee! Okay.
I'm not sure what you mean. I really actually don't.
Well, let's pretend it didn't happen. All right, moving on. Whoa.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, see the way the it's just being...
You keep going up, aiming up at the sky.
Well, no, it's not that I keep going up. It's that it keeps going to... Like, it slowly moves, and then it just jumps all of a sudden.
Oh.
I mean, I'll probably live, but at the same time, it's annoying. Stop that. Sir. I do not want any of your yellowness.
Your yellowness.
Is that racist?
No, but you know what is racist? Me, apparently.
Racism? What?
I got called.
You're like the least...
I know. It happened at work today. What? Why
Ooh,
is there battle music?
Please do tell.
Why is there...
Oh, there's still guys in here. They're just up top.
Oh. Anyway, so...
I don't actually care.
So, we've had to start, you know, implementing more security at my store. And because of,
okay,
you know, bad people and, you know, shit. The usual BS. So we went from being 24 hours to being to closing for a couple of hours at night to clean it up and, you know, just keep out the riffraff at the hour where they usually slink in at like 2 a.m. and, you know, shoo everybody out the door. That's the big one, is everyone has to leave right now.
Kind of deal. We're closed. Get out.
Yeah.
Right. That seems entirely fine.
Yeah. We open up at 4 o'clock in the morning now. And there was this guy.
Ooh.
I walked in and I looked around at the usual problem areas, like the back corners of the place where there's less visibility and people like to hide out in those little areas. And I saw this one guy that I recognized as being someone who likes to come in and just loiter in the building and just stay there for like 6+ hours and not buy anything.
That seems weird.
He doesn't do anything other than just sit on his phone and just do fuck all. But he's there for 6 hours and doesn't buy anything. So he's just... And we have policies against that kind of stuff at work.
But at the same time, it's kind of hard to enforce that stuff. So
yeah, I know. It's annoying, but still. But we also have another thing of... You're not allowed to sleep in the building because it's not a fucking... You can't sleep here, people.
It's not a hotel, fuckers.
Yeah, I know, right? It's not much to ask. People come here to get caught, get food and drinks and use the internet, and that's basically all that is expected of you.
For anybody that doesn't know, Kenathis basically works in like a cafe kind of environment.
I work at Tim Hortons.
Yeah.
I'm a Canadian that works at Tim Hortons. Yes.
See, I know what Tim Hortons is. And I'm sure any of our Canadian viewers know what Tim Hortons is. But for anybody that doesn't know what Tim Hortons is, aka most Americans, Tim Hortons is a goddamn institution.
Oh, no, I'm sure plenty of lots of Americans know what Tim Hortons is. It's a stereotype.
I hope so.
It is.
Like, in Canada, you can drive 20 or for an hour to get to the next town with there being nothing between one town and the other except like 3 Tim Hortons. That's the stereotype.
Yeah, there's a lot of them. There's a lot of them. Anyway.
And they have the best fucking coffee. Anyway, continue.
Anyway, so I see him, but he's like sleep, got his head down in his arms, and he's like hiding behind his usual like shopping bag full of shit that he eats while sitting there doing nothing. He comes in with like a bag full of like chips and shit and just sits there.
Wait, so he comes to your freaking cafe and doesn't even buy your shit?
No, he brings his own snacks and just sits there on his phone with his fucking aviators and his dumb hat. Anyway, I spot him because he always wears the same fucking thing on his head. This weird, like, I don't know what it is. It's not a hat. It's like, I know why you're in this room now. I remember this item. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
There's that one wall.
We passed this like many episodes ago.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway. I swear.
Yeah, anyway.
So I recognize the guy and he's like got his head down and he's sleeping. So I go over there and like bang on his table. Like, I tell him, hey, you can't do that here. You can't sleep here. People can't do that. That thing is just not dying. Anyway.
Once again, entirely logical.
Yeah. Yeah. So I do that, and he like wakes up, and he sits up, and I leave. So I gotta get my shit. I gotta get to work, because I'm the baker. So So I do that, and I just keep an eye on him out of the, like, every so often. And like half an hour later, I notice that he has just put his head back down, and he's sleeping again. So I like go over there and I bang on his table again, and I wait for him to wake up and look at me. Like, I tell him to his face, "You can't sleep here. There's a switch somewhere else that you have to break behind another disposable wall." So I tell him that he can't sleep. We have policies against people sleeping And I tell him that we also have policies against people loitering in the store.
Right.
And then I don't remember if he said anything or anything like that, but I leave him. Then I go. I leave him alone, and he's just like sitting there, and he's just sitting there. Every time I look at him, he's just sitting there. And then I notice, wait a minute, he's just sitting there, like ramrod straight, with his aviator glasses on, and he's just looking straight dead ahead. I look at him. His head is just resting against the wall behind him, and he's asleep, sitting up. I'm like, motherfucker. So I go,
mother humper.
So I go to the manager who came in, and I tell them that this guy's been here since 4 a.m. because I talked to the night shift, the graveyard shift, who was there, and I tell him that he's been there since when I opened up, and the entire time. He's just been there, and wow, that wall just is not having it.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck. It says, locks keyed to space pirate life signs only. Well, fuck your space pirate life signs. I want to get in there.
Maybe there's something invisible that you need to scan, or a thermal visor or something?
Maybe. Nope.
I feel like there's...
Do I need to kick punt one in there?
No, I don't think so. I feel like there's just something you're missing.
Yeah, I agree. So what did the manager say?
Anyways, I explained everything. This guy has just been here, and he's not... Oh, it's right there. That's
yeah,
it.
I'm smart.
So I explained that he's been here for 4 hours. He bought a $1.99 donut when he got here, and he has been sleeping in his corner, and he didn't even eat his donut. He just used it as an excuse. So I tell her...
I'm a customer.
Yeah,
you can't kick me out.
Basically. So I tell him all this shit about him and what he's been doing. He's just been sitting here doing nothing, and he's been sleeping, and I have told him he can't sleep. I've woken him up twice, and I told him he can't sleep here and he can't loiter around here. Hey, is that the flamethrower?
It is.
Oh, boy. My least favorite super weapon. Oh boy.
Oh yeah, we'll use it once and then never again.
Yeah. And that I've woken him up twice and I've explained things to him, and she's like, okay, yeah, get him out of here. Tell him he's got to leave or you'll call security. And like, okay, I have permission from the manager to boot him out. So me being the not jerk I am, I have to work myself up to being an asshole.
Right.
So
you're like the least confrontational person I know, I swear to God.
It takes me like 10 minutes to get around to actually going over there, and because he's got his head down again.
Right.
So I go over there and I knock on his table and I tell him I tell him that I've already talked to him twice now. I've warned him, and I've explained the store's policy to him, and that now he has to leave because this is the third time. And he's like,
because we're done with your shit, sir.
Yeah, and my manager has told me to tell you to get out, or we're calling security. So, and he just he just looks at me, and he's just like, "What are you talking about? I've only just gotten here, and I'm a paying customer." And he points at his. He points at his one untouched donut that he's had for 4 hours. And I just tell him, I don't care.
Please
leave.
You've
been here for 4 hours since the store opened, and you've just been loitering around. You've been here sleeping. I've told you twice to not do that, that you can't do that here. And he's just like, you can't tell me what to do. I'm a paying customer. And I know my rights. I'm allowed to be here and do what I want.
Your rights don't matter.
And I just turned around. I threw up my hands. I turned around and I walked off. And I immediately just grabbed one of the phones and called for building security to come down. So they come down and they literally just spend like 10 minutes talking to him. And because he just won't leave. Then he comes over to me, and asks what the actual situation is, because this guy is telling me that that you're just picking on him because you're a racist. Because of course, because I am a pasty white Canadian, and this guy this asshole just happens to be black. So it's just like whatever, man.
And quite frankly, like, you don't know what's going on in that guy's life.
No, I don't.
But at the same time,
I don't know,
you got a
and
job
I don't,
to do.
I don't know, and I don't care. And I'm following the fucking rules.
Right.
I've gone through all the steps necessary to do something about this, to deal with
and
this,
like,
issue.
And it's like, I apologize, but quite frankly, get out.
So I'm looking, there are two white guys that work. There are two Caucasians that work at my store, and I'm one of them. Everyone else is like Asian or Filipino or Brazilian or whatever. And it's just
a real multicultural city you live in there, Canada.
It is.
I know. I've never been there, but I know.
And so it's just like, and I'm talking to the security guard, and I'm just like, oh, that's cute. I told him that I knew he'd fucking say something like that, and I figured from this guy, just from what he, from how he, like, was talking to me,
yeah.
What did you just run into? What is that music?
Chozo Ghost.
Oh, those chuckle fucks.
Oh, what the?
Wow, that
hello,
just, what
that
just
was
happened?
Interesting.
It bounced off
him because he was invulnerable, and then it came back.
And it just, it 180'd and came right back at him. Wow, I've never seen that happen before.
That's some damn good tracking there, Powerbomb, or Power Missile.
Good job, Power Missile, MVP.
Man, I don't understand why people gotta, like, if you have a legitimate concern or something like that, like, people saying that guy doesn't like me because he's racist cheapens the argument of people that actually have problems.
I know.
From racists.
Playing the racist card just because you're not getting your way just makes it worse. It's just like, the guy tells me what this guy's claiming, and I'm like, I look at him and like, this guy has been here for 4 hours and he's just been loitering in his table, and he's been sleeping at his table. I've knocked on him, and I've told him twice that he can't do that here. I have explained store policy to him more than once, and I even discussed the issue with my manager before confronting him. Please make him leave.
Did they?
Yes. After I explained it to him, the guy like, okay, I'll go talk to him. And then he went back over, and they spent another 10 minutes talking, because apparently this guy just won't fucking give up. He just doesn't know when to fucking stop. Because I guess he has nothing better to do than to just squat in my store and do nothing. But stare at his phone or something? I don't know.
Wait, he had a smartphone?
Yes! I mean, this guy's not homeless. Well, this guy doesn't look dirty or gross or like a drug addict or anything. He's just, to be fair,
he could still be homeless, but I understand what you're saying.
I mean, he doesn't look like it. And then the security guard even said, this guy doesn't look like the usual problem people. What's the problem?
Right.
Yeah. So, I mean, yeah. So he's just, I guess he just has nothing better to do than to squat here and just be a kind of a vague nuisance. But I had to get him out.
That's a weird ass situation.
It is, but I had to get him out of there because
it was
like getting close to lunch, and I didn't have much time left to deal with it before the place got really fucking busy and really crowded with construction workers who are going to want tables. So I gotta push this guy out. I gotta get this fucker out of here because paying customers want to sit down. Anyway. So.
Well, that's a fun situation.
He managed to negotiate with the offending man that he would leave within 10, he said he would leave in 10 minutes. And I watched him like, okay, whatever. I'll keep an eye on him. He said, security guard said that if he doesn't leave within 10 minutes, just you can call us back or call the police, do whatever you want.
To be honest, the security guards are not necessarily in a better situation. I mean, they're sitting there going, oh, we got to get this guy out of here. I mean, we don't want to lay hands on a guy because then he's going to claim assault. And I mean, there's no good situation for anybody in that case.
No, I know. But, and then I looked at the clock and I watched this guy, and exactly 10 minutes on the dot, he gets up and leaves.
Wow.
Exactly 10 minutes. It was just like, I was even going to be willing, like, if this guy was going to keep pushing the issue, I was even going to wait, give him an extra like 5 minutes, just so when I call like the police or the security again, I would tell him, I even gave him an extra couple minutes to get his shit and leave, but he just wouldn't fucking go. But he left on 10 minutes. Just, I don't know what, just to squeeze everything.
And then he probably went to the Timmy's or
maybe 1 minute down the block to the Starbucks and probably went in there. But
at that point, you didn't care.
As soon as he was out of the store, I didn't care anymore. It's just the gall of him to try and to just like when the security comes to say, hey, dude, you gotta leave.
You gotta go.
And you just start.
You don't sit there and be like.
You don't
he's
sit there and just start escalating the issue into some kind of race problem. It's just like, dude,
ooh.
Come on. Does this hat? Do you? Really have to?
Fuck.
Oh, you fell down again. Like, do you really have to push this? Keep pushing it. And I mean, if it wouldn't be so bad if this guy wouldn't just squat here and not do anything. Like, if he was actually, if he would just spend like an extra like $2, like on a coffee or something, and like validate.
And then he could claim that he was a writer or something.
Yeah,
you know?
Just do something to make it make yourself an actual customer or something. But he just starts like shitting on other customers, saying about how there's all these other people who come in here with laptops and stuff and yeah, well, you know what? They actually, you know, they kind of buy food and coffees and sit here and do their work and stuff. You're just sitting here with an uneaten donut in your lap, and you're just sitting here sleeping.
Oh, boy.
Ridiculous bullshit.
People are scum.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually have a really good story about that, but you being a racist apparently took up like 25 minutes. Alright, so next time on Character Select, I will tell you my story about people who are scum.
Oh boy.
And it's delightful.
That's great.
So thank you very much for watching. Make sure to click that like button down below if you liked it. We're still collecting upgrades, I apologize, but we're getting through.
Many upgrades are to be had.
And Knathis,
yes.
What do you have to say for yourself, you racist motherfucker?
I hate everybody that's not white!
Oh god, please don't take that out of context.
Oh, yeah, I know, right?